Hey everyone, welcome to the channel and I'm back with a new Genshin Impact video. So we got some new updates on the upcoming reputation system and the exploration progress system in the patch version 1.1 of Genshin Impact. So there are a bunch of stuff to go through, so let's dive right into it. So first of all, you need to be adventure rank 25 or above, and also you need to complete the Archon missions for Mondstadt and Leeway respectively. So after unlocking the city reputation system in Mondstadt and Leeway, you can access them from these two new NPC, Hertha and Miss You, in both regions respectively. So the means to progress into this new city reputation system can be done by completing the bounties and requests that has been added in this new update. So there are total 3 bounties and 3 requests every week, and also you can explore the world to gain some reputation level. Also, you can complete the quests in respective regions to also achieve reputation level. So whoever is at level 40, adventure level 40, might have completed this quest already, so kudos to you. And also, this reputation level do not share their experience in regions, like the reputation level for Mondstadt and reputation level for Leeway is different. Both of them are independent. So next up are the rewards. So there are total 8 levels in this, and each level has some rewards, so we are going to look into that now. The first thing is the Animoculus Resonance Stone and the Geoculus Resonance Stone. So you can obtain them at reputation level 2 at both regions. So you get Animoculus Resonance Stone in Mondstadt at reputation level 2 and Geoculus Resonance Stone at reputation level 2 of Leeway. So what this does is, when you are in Mondstadt and you use this, it will show you the nearest possible Animoculus. So if you are missing one or two Animoculus that you can't find, no matter how much you look, so this is going to help you a long way. And it has cooldown of 300 seconds, and the Animoculus Resonance Stone and the Geoculus Resonance Stone can be used only in the respective region. So next up is the Wind Catcher, and this is one of the things that I was looking forward to, and I was knew that is going to come in this update. So what this does is, it gathers the Animogranas, that is the flies that can, when you catch 3 of them, that currents a wind current. So you can gather them and use them whenever you want. So you can gather up to 5 of them, and it also has a cooldown of 100 seconds, and you cannot use this in battles. So next is Condensed Resin. I know this is the one that everyone was looking at, I think. So what this does, before that, it unlocks at reputation level 3 in Leeway. So you can craft this at the crafting bench, where you craft all that potions and I don't know. So the recipe for this is pretty simple. You only need 1 crystal core that you can find from the crystal flies, and 40 resins and 100 mora. So what you can do is save on 1 day of 120 resins and make 3 of this, and also you can only make 3 of this at a time, so that's 120 resin for you, and use it on an another day when you want to farm and obtain double the reward. So it's pretty sweet, I guess. So next up, we have this thing called NRE. I don't know what this is, but it's like a portable food backpack that you can obtain at city reputation level 5 in Mondstadt. And what this does is, you can store up to 2 items, 1 health revival item, HP recovery item, and 1 revival item, like 1 item to revive your characters. And what this does is, whenever your character is on low HP, it will automatically use this food item. And whenever someone falls on your team, like whenever someone dies in your team, it will automatically revive that guy. So it's kind of a very good item. I don't know, you don't have to open the menu. It's just quality of life stuff. So next up, we have the portable cooker. I would call it portable cooker. It says here, Adapti Seeker Stove. So that's portable cooker for you, man. Portable, I don't know. So also, you can obtain this at reputation level 5 in Leeway. And what this does is, you can use it whenever you want to cook food on the go. It also has a cooldown time of 300 seconds. And this thing will break if you enter into combat. So mind you, your portable cooker will break, okay? You don't want that. So next is portable waypoint. So this is one of the things that my friend was looking for. And yeah, I think this is very good. You can obtain it at Adventure Rank. Oh my god, please kill me. It's a reputation rank, city reputation rank 6 in Mondstadt. And what this does is you can make this portable waypoint and it will last for 7 days. Okay, so suppose you have to farm in certain region and you have to go to that, you have to run towards that region from certain waypoint. So what you can do it now, you can just set a waypoint near that location where you have to farm or where you go usually, and then use it for 7 days. Also, this you can only place one portable waypoint at a time, and the first one breaks if you make a second one. So keep that in mind. Next up is the Animo Treasure Compass and the Geo Treasure Compass. You can unlock them at a reputation level 6 and 6 of Mondstadt and Liwe respectively. So what this does is when you are in the vicinity, like near the chest, and you can see, as you can see, you get an additional button on the screen. You don't have to go into the menu. So whenever you have, when you make this, you get an additional option in your screen. If you press that, command is given Z, I guess. When you press that, it will show you a waypoint towards it, like it will glow a line, like it will show a glowing line path, as you can see over here. It also has a cooldown of 5 seconds after use, and if you find the chest after use, it will go on a cooldown for 30 seconds. Also, the Animo Treasure Compass can be only used in Mondstadt and the Geo Treasure in Liwe, you know. Next up is the city features that are mining outcourt researches. So what are this? You need to be reputation level 2 in each region to unlock this. What you will find in that, when you talk to the Wagner, the blacksmith in Mondstadt, this guy, and Master Zhang, the blacksmith in Liwe, this guy, they will tell you where to find the deposit, so you don't have to look into the interactive map, or you don't have to mark the locations of that. When you reach the city reputation level 2, they will tell you where the chunks are. So that's a very, very sweet touch, I guess. Also, after reaching rank 30, you will be able to mine magical crystal chunks. So merchant discount is the next one, and I think this is kind of useful. I have never traded with a merchant or anything like that. So if you reach a reputation level 4 in Mondstadt and Liwe, you can unlock this. And what this does is, after unlocking the merchant discounts, you will be able to enjoy discounted price at designated merchants. I don't know. I have never used a merchant before, so maybe this is a good thing. I might need them. So next up is the reputation name card style, and personally I'm not into name cards that much. If you are, this is good for you because you get 4 new name cards, and I think they are pretty easy to get because you get them on reputation level 4 and 7 in both regions respectively, and they are quite nice, I will say. So next is the food recipes, the new food recipes that you can unlock at reputation 1, 4, 7 each region respectively. So I don't know what this 6 recipes does, but And now the big thing, the first cosmetic item you can get in this game. So these are the gliders that you can get after completing the city reputation system, because you get that at level 8. So they are at maxed out at level 8. So one with the Mondstadt is called Wings of Azure Wind, and from the Liwe city reputation system you get Wings of Golden Flight. I think they are both very cool looking. The blue one you can equip on Cryo and Hydro characters and Electro characters, I guess. And the golden one is, I think, the best one for D-loop people, and it will look very good. Exploration progress system is the next one, and what it will show you is the amount of exploration you have done in that region. So it will show you the percentage you have explored, and I think this might be completed for most of us who are at adventure 36 plus. I don't know, even some guys who have adventure 20, you might have completed this, you might have explored everything. Next up is the archive system. So this is a thing, like it's like a diary. It keeps tabs on everything you do in the game, the geography, the equipments, the material, books, and it also has the tutorials for stuff. So I don't know if this was in the game because I didn't look into this kind of stuff. So there are four major things you can look into this archives. So these are equipments, the materials, the tutorials, and the character archives. So first of all, the equipments, what this does is it shows, it basically is when you open a menu, weapon menu, it you will see the weapon information and all that, and it basically is the introduction or story of the weapon or story of the your artifact set. It's kind of that. For the materials, you will find every single material, from food, from trophies, from utility items, from resources, everything. You can find the information, what this does, what are there, what are, I don't know, kind of stuff, some quality of life stuff. And geography is kind of a new stuff. This is the kind of stuff you can find in most of the Assassin's Creed game, where you reach a certain point and you can access their location information. It's kind of an Assassin's Creed thing. So as you can see in this image, you reach the waypoint and there's area highlighted in purple color glow. If you press viewpoint, you can get this screen which shows you information of that area, some kind of information and an image. And that's cool, I guess. And also the books are being added to this archive now. So some previously collected books will be removed from your inventory and transferred to the archive. So if you are missing any book in your inventory, if you read some, they will be in your archives, so don't worry. Also, this is one of the good things you can find in this update, the tutorial. So remember those things when you encounter new elemental resonance or elemental reaction, you get G, you press G and it shows you what you have discovered. So all of them will be in this tab, the tutorial tab. So you can go anytime in that and anytime you can look into that, what kind of elemental reaction you have acquired, what kind of elemental reactions are there, information on the enemies and all that stuff. Okay, and last up is the character archive system. So I think this is a very neat system where you can categorize your characters pretty distinctively. So character owned, character by type, character by elemental, character by weapons, weapon type, and also we get to filter the characters. Like if you, as you can see in this image, if you want a cryo character with a bow, so you can find them. If you want a pyro character with a bow, if you want a pyro character with a sword, so you can actually discriminate them easily. So I think that that's all for this update. And yeah, there's quite a lot of stuff and just the city reputation system and world progress system. So, and that's it for this update. Hope you all enjoyed it. Thank you for watching. See you in next one.